The Fick principle to assess the cardiac output is discussed in this video, which is very basic methodology to assess the cardiac output proposed by the Fick. And echocardiogram is one of the advanced technology by which we can record or measure the cardiac output and physiological and pathophysiological functions of the heart. And however, I would like to take you to the way back in 1870, where the Fick, A.E. Fick, was presented his research on cardiac output measurement in the conference in 1870 July, and thereafter. So his proposal was coined as Fick's contribution for the measurement of the cardiac output. So he proposed a theory in which an organ or entire body utilizes the oxygen, given oxygen, and it is measured from the artery and also measured in the veins of the respective concentrations of the given substance or oxygen. On the basis of the concentrations, we can calculate the cardiac output according to Fick's principle. So in this illustration, the known amount of the oxygen being given to the individual per minute, after minute breathing, we can assess the amount of oxygen present in the veins and arteries. So arteries indicates the pure oxygen entry into the body, veins oxygen indicate after utilization concentration of the oxygen. So here VO2, the volume of oxygen given in 1 minute or unit time, and divided by arteriovenous concentrations of the particular oxygen or any given substance. If we know these values, we can calculate the cardiac output according to Fick's law or Fick's principle. Here 250 ml of oxygen is breathed by 1 minute, and 190-140 oxygen concentration in the arteriovenous levels respectively, and will eventually get 5 liters per minute is the flow or cardiac output by the left ventricular output, is known as cardiac output. So this is how we can calculate the cardiac output basis on the Fick's principle. And determination of the cardiac output by indicator or dilution method, dye dilution method. And in this method, we administrate the known amount of the radioactive substance or dye into the brachial vein. So here the radioactive substance or dye being injected into the brachial vein. So once we inject the substance eventually go to the heart and come back to the arteries. And here, before going into the further, I would like to focus on the substance of use should have some basic qualities. The substance should not metabolize or should not degrade by any metabolism, or should not affect the hemodynamics, and the substance obviously should be easily measurable in the arterial sample. These are the characteristics of the substance to be used to assess the cardiac output. The series of sample from the brachial artery to be collected, the sample of the blood for the assessment of the substance concentration in each circulation. Once we inject the radioactive substance, obviously the substance or dye should go to the heart and come back to the brachial artery once it completes its circulation. So the series of sample concentration would be changed in each circulation. Here the definition of the cardiac output, the amount of indicator injected divided by its average concentration in arterial blood after a single circulation through the heart. Here the time in seconds taken in the x-axis and the concentration of the substance is taken on the y-axis. The series of sample from the brachial artery to be measured the concentration of the substance, which is now gradually completing peak and coming down, giving a notch and again peaking. So these from notch, we have an extension, extrapolation of the graph up to the 39 second, which indicates one complete circulation in normal circumstances. So this is how the brachial arterial concentration of the substance increases peak and decreases its concentration and again increases its concentration. So it shows the circulatory phases, first circulation, second circulation, and so on. So the extrapolation of the notch would give us complete one circulatory phase of the average concentration of the substance from the brachial arterial sample of every 5 seconds. And during the exercise situation, the circulation of every phase completes in very short time, that's around 10 seconds. So this peak indicates during exercise measurement. And the first one indicates the measurement of the average concentration of the substance in the normal condition. Now, basis on this, we can calculate the cardiac output. The E indicates the amount of the substance being infused into the circulatory system through vein, brachial vein, and the integral of average concentration from 0 to the known amount concentration in given time. The C indicates the concentration of the substance measured in the brachial artery for every 5 seconds. So basis on this, for example, we can calculate the cardiac output. If the substance is 5 milligram injected into the circulatory system, the average concentration is absorbed 1.5 milligrams per liter. So we will get the number 5 divided by 1.5 in 39 seconds, that is one circulation is around 3.3 liters per 39 seconds. For 60 seconds or 1 minute, so we have to multiply 3.3 into 60 divided by 39 seconds, we will get around 5.12 liters per minute is a cardiac output under dye dilution method. And in second graph, during exercise, the cardiac output can be measured by obtaining the similar the samples. So which is completing in 10 seconds, the amount of substance here 5 milligrams and the average concentration is recorded 1.56 milligrams per deciliter. And here we will get around the number 3.2 liters supply per 10 seconds. Here in exercise, the cycle completes in 10 seconds. And now 3.2 into 60 upon 10, we will get 19.2 liters per minute. So this is moderate exercise situation. This is how we can calculate the cardiac output with different methods.